magic dragon lived by the sea. And frolicked in the autumn mist in a land called Annalee.
Once, not too long ago, there was nobody. If nobody was in a room by himself, the room was deserted. If nobody had lunch with a friend, the friend was alone. Who cares about nobody, you ask? Somebody did. His name was Terry. And to him, nobody was as real as a brother or best friend.
What do you want to do now? Carve faces out of potatoes and stick them end to end? I get it. A totem pole. Great idea. Come on.
Terry was a very special person, gifted with a hidden wonderment. Even when he was 3 years old, others did not perceive things as Terry did. For example, all they saw was the crack in the back wall of the house. But to Terry, it became a magical pathway out of his confines to a place where the sun lived. By the time he was 4, his very special qualities confused those about him and sometimes made them jealous.
That's no castle. That's a duck.
What kind of dope makes ducks out of sand?
Terry needed a friend, a companion of his own frame of mind, with whom to share wonders and discoveries, exhilarations and disappointment, trinkets and treasures. But there was nobody to fill that need. And since nobody was all Terry had, nobody became his friend.
And he came from the sky in my dresser drawer. And he looks like that duck I always make up. With a saucepan hat and a feather, and his name is Nobody.
You called?
I've been waiting for you. Want to do something together?
If I had a middle name, together would be it.
And that's how the none and only Mr. Nobody danced his way into Terry's life. Oh, extraordinary things were in store for them. And me too.
We'll return to Puff the Magic Dragon after these messages.
Puff the Magic Dragon and the incredible Mr. Nobody. Sponsored by all your friends at Kellogg's of Battle Creek. Hope this special program helps make it a great day for your whole family.
What's rockin', rabbits?
Oh, we were hoping to do a number with the Kellogg's Raisins.
'Cause they sing with such flavor.
Well, try a warm-up.
A one, a two, a one.
Two scoops of raisins are the reason Kellogg's Raisin Brand's so pleasing.
I ripen two scoops of raisins for every box as part of this nutritious breakfast.
Two scoops of raisins,
yeah, two.
In Kellogg's Raisin Brand.
Now that's a number I can scoop.
I think he means dig.
Yeah.
Apple, Jack, cinnamon toasty, Apple Jack. You need a good breakfast like everyone should. And who knows Apple Jack looks good? Apple, Jack, the ball in the hole. He's a tasty bowl of cinnamon toasty, apple tasty, Kellogg's Apple Jack.
Part of this complete breakfast.
Apple, Jack.
We now return to Puff the Magic Dragon.
So what's new? Find out anything today?
Uh-huh. Flowers sing.
By golly, you're right. Fairy Zaka, Fairy Zaka. Got any new squishy jokes?
You like squishy jokes too?
If I had a middle name, Squishy would be it.
Well, I'm working on a new one. Listen, never was a feather, and no one knew the rules. And
And that's how all the cherries went.
two squishy, squishy pools. Wow, we write great squishy stuff together.
Never was a feather, and no one knew the rules. And that's how all the cherries went to squish in squishy pools. Terry and nobody, what a pair of friends. The limits were the skies above and where the rainbows end. Spoons turned into lollipops, then forests red and blue. Terry's wish for a special friend had finally come true. They laughed and played the whole year long. The months, they just grew past. And now young Terry, he was six, and school came at last.
Just think, son, your first day at school.
You're not nervous, are you, dear?
Not me. It's nobody's first day, too. You nervous? Nobody's not nervous, so I'm not either.
Imaginary friends are okay at his age, dear. He'll outgrow it.
Terry outgrew his trousers, but not his special friend. Together they did everything from morning to day's end. Terry grew like sprouting beans, his mind was like a rocket. But nobody was always there, hid in Terry's pocket.
I love Peschetti.
If I had a middle name, Peschetti would be it.
Know what else I love?
What?
Weather. Wish I could eat it.
Eat a rainstorm?
Sure. And summer, but especially a snowy day, like now. Know what would be even better?
What?
If instead of raining or snowing, it Peschetti'd.
Hey, let's get your paints. And make a picture.
Wow, that'd be the greatest.
Never ain't forever when teacher makes the rules. And squishy cherries just don't float, at least in Terry's school.
Terry, this is just silly. You must paint real trees and houses, not spaghetti.
But that's not the way I see it.
Real trees, Terry, and real houses. And make sure nobody helps you.
Next time I'll just tell them nobody did it, then I won't get blamed.
Terry was so hurt and sad, so his talent, he just hid it. When someone said, did you do that? He said, nobody did it. Soon he believed that all his talent came from his dear friend. Sometimes we talk ourselves into what starts out as pretend.
Oh, we're so proud that your school principal recommended you to Professor Katzendorfer, the world-famous music teacher. You're so talented, dear.
I do not the music recognize. Who composed, please?
Nobody, sir.
And how still could there be music if nobody wrote it?
Oh, he wrote lots. Nobody's a duck.
Duck? What is meant a duck already?
Don't you like ducks?
Tunnel ducks? Peking ducks? Why for do das music mit der ducks verspritzen? Pianos der eggs don't lay? Und there is no music als ducks?
Well, I guess you'd understand if you met him.
Who?
Nobody.
Impossible! Impossible! Ich nicht gewesen so lesson, wenn der Kinder was a Katzenjammer. He has maybe talent. When he wishes to be serious, bring him to me back. Till then, I sum the situation in two words. Impossible!
It's sad, I know, it once was told in some old dragon song. When children learn to pretend, friends can't stay the whole life long. Pretended ducks are wonderful, but then it's time to grow. It's so hard to say goodbye, as we magic dragons know.
Son, I've never lied to you, have I? Then listen to me, please. And try to understand.
Terry's father attempted to explain that nobody was an imaginary friend. He spoke with infinite kindness, but the more he spoke, the more confused Terry became.
Aw, Dad, don't. You got me all mixed up, kinda. I mean...
Darling, there's just no such person as nobody.
He's not a person. He's a duck. See? He's gone. What'd you do to him? You made him run away.
Oh, I don't know.
Imaginary friend or not, Terry was nobody without nobody. He lost interest. His marks dropped off in school. Who would laugh at his squishy jokes now? That is why, one night, after his mother had tucked him into bed, Terry ran away. He was determined to find his friend. But since his friend wasn't there to help him knot the sheets correctly... Dear me, is it raining children? Or are you from outer space?
No, sir. I come from that house.
That house? Impossible. Nobody lives there.
You know him, too?
A distant cousin, but a bosom companion. He lives there with a chap named, Terry.
I'm Terry.
You're right. He told me all about you. Did he ever mention me? Puff? Puff the Magic Dragon?
You're? Why, he taught me a song about you. We played it on the piano. But he's gone now. Ran away. I'm gonna look for him.
A search for nobody? How intriguing. May I join you?
Sure. Any friend of nobody is a friend of mine. Now, come on.
Which way?
Aw, gee. Nobody always helped me make plans.
Well, we can go to the right, or to the left, or we can take that road.
I know that road. I saw it when I was little. I bet nobody's just around that bend.
We'll return to Puff the Magic Dragon after these messages.
Laughing gas, sir?
Good. She'll spray it when the tiger says great, then grab the formula.
Goodness, my hero, Tony the Tiger.
Yes, ma'am.
And that's the secret formula for Kellogg's Sugar Frosted Flakes.
The very one that makes them a delicious part of this nutritious breakfast.
Yes, it makes them good.
Good. They're great. She must think I'm a real gas.
Frosted Flakes, original or banana.
What's new about Kellogg's Mini Wheats? Give you a little hint.
It's red and tastes delicious. Goes crunch and grows on trees. One taste and you will know it's new. Apple Frosted Mini Wheats.
New Kellogg's Apple Frosted Mini Wheats cereal. Whole grain shredded wheat with apple flavor in every bite. And part of this complete breakfast.
One taste and you will know it's new.
Apple
Frosted Mini Wheats.
We now return to Puff the Magic Dragon.
Welcome to the Fantiverse. What's that?
As the universe is to real people, so the Fantiverse is to imaginaries.
Nobody's just gotta be here. Come on.
You can't cross the border unless you fill out the proper forms.
That's nobody's hat.
Yes, he forgot it when he passed through.
Where is he?
In the Duck Pond of Delights. But you can't go there till you fill out these forms.
But this is just blank paper.
Not blank, expectant. It expects you to write a poem on it.
Puff, to get through, I've got to write a poem.
Write one of those squishy ones.
But I can't. Not without nobody to help me. It's different when nobody helps.
How is it different?
When the kids all make fun and call me names and...
Those kind of kids?
Terry is an egghead. Anybody writes poems is a jerk.
Get out of here, creep!
Make them go away, Puff.
I can't, but I can show you what they're really saying.
What?
Just look at them through one of my magic puffs.
Boy, I'd give anything to make words the way he does. Yeah, I'd make up lines for songs that help turn bad things good.
I'd just write something pretty for Mom on her birthday.
It ain't fair he can write poems.
Yeah!
Egghead.
Jerk.
Creep.
Envy, Terry, that's all it is. that confused, unfulfilled longing, confounding the heart and turning kind tongues cruel. You should feel sorry for them, not afraid.
I guess so.
Go ahead. Time's a-wasting.
I'll try. The night is more night, and gray is more gray, and empty's more empty when friends go away.
The sun's on the flowers, the rain's full of song. When friends are together, where true friends belong.
Okay.
Yeah, I wish it were a wreath of laurel. This map will help you find your friend. You may enter the Pantiverse.
I told you, you could do it by yourself.
No, I was thinking of nobody. Besides, your pencil was magic.
Oh, Terry.
Come on. Map says the Duck Pond of Delights is straight ahead. Proceed through landscape. Uh-oh. It's that Piscati land I painted.
A nation of noodles? A principality of pasta? A metropolis of macaroni.
Directions say, draw a boat to get across.
Clever. There are pencils and paints over here.
I can't draw anymore. Not without nobody.
I suppose it's up to me.
We can't cross a river on a banana. A rocking chair's no good. A boat, Puff, a boat. Whistler's mother!
Definitely not seaworthy. It's up to you, Terry.
But I can't paint stuff like this. Teacher said it was just dumb and silly.
You mean she didn't share your vision?
Huh?
Her world was the drab old mundane world most of us know.
What could be new from 9 to 5? I tote that barge and bale. Defrost some food, then watch TV. You call this life? It's jail.
Is that what the world's really like?
Unless someone like you comes along. Look at the world through terry-colored glasses.
Hey, a wall crack is the road to Oz. There's wonder in Paschetti. I'm full of rainbows, poems, and songs. That's as good as I can get.
I really make it like that?
You and that precious handful like you. Be you a dozen or a million who give the gift of vision unique. Better than Broadway. Terry, you can reach up and place a star in the sky. So don't worry what people say. Who can't even screw in a light bulb?
Yeah?
Yes?
I've been thinking. Maybe it wasn't me. Maybe I could paint this boat because I was wearing nobody's hat.
Oh, I see.
Puff! The wind blew it away.
You're on your own now.
What's that noise? Sounds like a piano.
It's coming from the opposite shore. What does your map call it?
Kleptomania.
This is definitely Kleptomania, the music kingdom. The map says to proceed harmoniously through.
There is no more harmony.
What's wrong around here?
The savage beast holds us in his power.
It is said music hath charms to soothe the savage beast. Surely you fellas can make music.
But how can we play music? We got no hands.
We're such busts.
The savage beast.
What can we do, Puff?
I guess it's up to you to soothe him. Play one of those tunes you composed.
But I didn't compose them. Nobody did. Don't you understand? That music didn't come from me.
Yes, it did. It came from everywhere and then through you.
Let me show you.
I think of that.
That third duck turned into a little boy.
You recognize him?
It's me. No, it's him. Nobody.
Good to see you, Terry. Gee, you came all this way to find me?
But when I saw what you really were, I saw me.
Funny, when I looked at you from the other side of the smoke ring, I saw me.
Then I must be you, and you must be me.
What a great thing to happen to two nice guys like us. Come on, let's do something together.
Yeah.
Imaginary friends are magic mirrors of your heart.
They're partly you.
And partly me.
And partly they're apart.
They can be balloons or blankets, rain or even rainbows.
Cause no one else can tell you how. Or where your brain goes.
Believe in you, believe in me, believe in who you are. Believe in your own special self and follow your own star.
Believe in you, believe in me, believe in who you are.
Believe in your own special self and follow your own star. Imaginary friends are just as real as sleepy dreams.
Pirates, ducks,
who knows what all that means?
And when you wake up, you remember parts to tell your friends.
So that's the way to make a dream that never, never ends.
Believe in you.
Believe in me.
Believe in who you are.
Believe in your own special self and follow your own star. Imaginary friends are just like hopes that might come true. One part smiles and one part tears, but all parts part of you. The specialness that each one has, unique in all creation, is found, I do believe, my friends, in your imagination.
Why, I could do all that stuff before. We're the same person.
And always will be. I promise.
You coming back with me?
Can't. The part of you that's you belongs back home. And the part that's me belongs here. Your dad was right.
Kind of sad.
Yup.
Well, if anybody cares, I have an idea. Nobody can come home with me.
Huh? Is Harnally part of the Fantiverse?
No farther away than the flight of a kite.
Gee, if nobody was with you, it'd be like I was with you. We'd all be together. Will you go with Puff?
Sure. I thought he'd never ask me.
Oh, indeed. Dear me, it must be later than I think again. We'd best be on our way.
Oh, nobody. You're the best friend a guy could ever have.
You're Tom's, too. If I had a middle name, Terry would be it.
There's an east wind, Honalee. Mustn't lose it.
Terry!
He's in the lilacs. The bush must have broken his fall.
Mom? Dad?
Oh, darling, are you hurt?
No, the rope broke.
Why were you climbing out of the window, son?
To find nobody. And I found him. And you know where he was? Inside me all the time. And that's where he always will be. And you know what else?
What, dear?
I gotta practice my piano.
We'll return to Puff the Magic Dragon after these messages.
That's a talented nose.
But wish he could find me fruit flavors like you can, Toucan.
Come, we'll follow my nose.
Come in.
It's always nose. For flavors of fruit, just follow my snoot.
That's a snoot.
Those natural orange and lemon cherry tastes. I can smell my Fruit Loops any place. Kellogg's Fruit Loop cereal, part of this nutritious breakfast. Ha ha, now that's a seal of approval.
Something special.